Hello, Dental Online Trainers. I'm Dr. Dennis Hartlieb, and welcome back for another edition of our Clinical Mini Tips. I have my lovely assistant, Erica, with me today. Today, we're going to be talking about facebows, or more particularly about earbows. I'm going to demonstrate how to take an earbow. So for those of you who haven't really had much experience, or maybe haven't picked up your earbow since dental school, I want to walk you through the step-by-step technique so you can predictably take an earbow in your practice. Now, why do you even need to take a facebow or an earbow? Well, if you take a look at my CPR for the Worn Dentition course, or my smile design, or our trial smile or smile preview courses, we talk about when you need to use a facebow or an earbow to be able to transfer the upper model or the upper cast to an articulator. Now, if you're doing a single tooth, you're doing a single molar or bicuspid, you probably don't need a facebow or an earbow. But if you're doing an anterior tooth, and you're worried about the midline angulation, it might be something that you need to consider. And certainly if you're doing more complex dentistry, if you're doing smile cases, if you're doing larger, more comprehensive cases, then I think that you really need to be working your case out on an articulator. All right, so let's get going. I'm going to show you how we work through our earbow system. The system that I'll be using today is a SAM3 facebow, and I'll show you why I like using the SAM3 system. All right, let me grab that. With the SAM3 and with most earbows, there's going to be two or three parts. The first part is going to be the plate that you're going to be using to register the upper teeth. So we have our upper plate. Then there's going to be the actual earbow itself, which we'll be demonstrating that. And then we're going to have the mechanism that connects the earbow to the plate that we're going to be using for registering the patient's upper occlusal arch. So we're going to start out with the upper plate, and I want to try it in. I'm going to lean Erica back, and when I try in the upper plate, I want to make sure that as I slide it in, it's almost like putting in an impression tray. Like an impression tray, I'm going to slide it and turn it in, and I want the middle of the plate to be centered in the patient's face. So I'll literally stand behind the patient and take a look to make sure that I'm centered. All right, once I've practiced and I explain to the patient that we're going to be putting some putty on this or some sort of material, they at least have a sense of the feeling of how this is going to go in. So you want to have a couple things ready when you're ready to do this. Number one, you need to have your plate available. You need to have a sort of a fast setting bite registration material. You're going to need a couple cotton rolls, and you're going to want a timer because you want to know when your material is set up. All right, so let me get my materials ready. If you saw the earbow or the SAM3 facebow earbow technique, you know that we were able to place in the mounting plate and connect the earbow. Then out of the mouth, we were able to parallel and make sure that everything was nice and balanced to the horizon. With the coise facial analyzer, it's all done at once. So essentially what I want to do is I'm going to use this rod to check for being down the midline of the patient's face. And then I'm going to be using the floor as my horizon. So I need to have the patient laying down at about 180 degrees. I'm going to have the patient sometimes tip their chin up because I want to be looking straight down the patient's face when I do my coise facial analyzer. I'm going to practice. I want to make sure that I have it in a sort of a good form and I understand exactly how I want this positioned before I go and take the facebow or the coise facial analyzer. All right, so I'll have Erica open. And again, I have the center of the teeth by the notch. And then I will hold it in place and I'm looking right down the middle of the face and I'm looking to see if the mid bow is down the middle of the patient's face. And then I'm looking to make sure that my fox plane is parallel to the horizon, or in this case, sort of perpendicular to the floor. Once I get a feel for that positioning, then I'm ready to go to register that. To register, I'm going to be using my bite registration material. This is Futar D from Kettenbach. I like Futar D a lot. It's a great bite registration material because I like the way it flows and I like the hardness of the material after it hardens. It makes it very easy for me to trim. And it has about a 1 minute set. So when we use our materials, our bite registration materials, we have to make sure that they're bleeding evenly before we put on our tip. And then we want to make sure that it's flowing evenly. So I'm going to squirt out a little bit before I add it on to the plate. So as I mount, as I bring it to the plate, I want to have an even layer of material across the arch. And then I bring it right to the mouth. I center it, I check to make sure that I'm parallel to the face and that it's perpendicular to the floor. And then I hold it for 1 minute. After 1 minute, the material is hardened. I'm going to take two cotton rolls. I'm going to ask Eric to bite down gently on the cotton rolls. Great. Now I want to verify that I've actually recorded her upper cast in a registration that's parallel to the horizon. So I'm actually going to seat Erica up and I'm going to bring her to the dental assistant stool and I'm going to verify, and if everything looks good, then I'm going to take a photograph of that. If I did not accurately record the arch parallel to the horizon, I'm going to have to redo the bite and redo the whole coiced facial analyzer. So I'm going to seat her up so I can get a better look. So what I like about the SAM3 earbow is that the mechanism to connect the facebow or the earbow to the plate is just one screw, and that connects everything together. The one thing that I did not describe was a nason piece. This little piece here is going to rest into the bridge of the nose area, which is going to help support the earbow. I'll show you how we do that in just a minute. All right, so first, I'm going to take my earbow and I'm going to slide it so that it goes into Erica's ears. And I'm going to use this nason to support along the bridge of the nose. I'm going to ask Erica to come up and with her hands to support the earbow as we slide it into her ears. I'm going to loosen the nason. And then that is going to help support the earbow. Now I'm going to connect the earbow mounting jig to the mounting plate. And that will come in and slide right on to the mounting plate. And then with a single screw, that holds it in place. All right, so now my earbow is connected onto the mounting plate, but I have not tightened it yet because what I need to do now is check to make sure that this is parallel to the horizon. All right, so once I have this in place, I'm going to lock this mechanism in the center, and that will keep the earbow nice and firm. All right, now you can do this one of two ways. I can lean the chair all the way back and then use the floor as my horizon and then be able to connect or screw tighten the one mounting jig. Or what I prefer to do is actually to seat the patient up and move them to the dental assistant stool and do it while they're sitting upright. So that's what we're going to do now. We're going to seat the chair up and I'm going to move Erica over to our other chair. Okay, so we've moved Erica to the assistant stool. I find it much easier for me to be able to evaluate, is the facebow parallel to the horizon? Now, it may be, and it's not uncommon, that sometimes one patient's one ear may be higher or lower than the other ear. So very often I have to take the earbow and maybe move it up on one ear and lower on the other ear so that I can get it level with the horizon because the ears are not parallel to the horizon. So I'm going to take a step back, I'm going to look, and as I look at it, I can see that the right, her left side is a little bit lower, so I'm going to tilt it. You can use a little level or you can eyeball this. And so I tend to eyeball and I'm just looking to make sure that it's parallel. Once I'm satisfied that the earbow is parallel to the horizon, then I can go ahead and close down and tighten that one screw mechanism which connects the bite plate to the earbow. Now there's one more thing I do before I finish with the facebow or with the earbow. I want to take a photograph. So I'll pull out my 35 millimeter camera and I'm going to take an image of this so that when we mount the case on the articulator in the lab, if there's a cant to the model, I can go back to the photograph and see if I did, if I took a bad facebow, if there was something that I missed. All right, looks good on the image. Before I remove the facebow or the earbow, I just again want to make sure that that's nice and tight. If everything's good, then I can go ahead and release each of the mechanisms. And then we're going to take that, and then we'll have Erica open. We take out the cotton rolls, and then we pop that off from the side. And that is how we get ourselves a nice, predictable earbow. Then we're able to transfer that to the articulator. All right, Dental Online trainers, thanks to Erica for helping us out with this course. So I look forward to seeing you at future DOT courses. Until then, be well, and here's to good dentistry.